morning today, my brothers and sisters. This is JCC on this Sunday morning. I felt the Holy Spirit came and touched me today, asked me to come in and really give a rhema explanation, a rhema word for today. Based off of the sermon that we provided, I felt the Holy Spirit came and asked me to come back in and kind of explain that in today's terms and allow us to see what to do in times like these, when we don't know what to do, what we are to do in times like these. And if you allow me, I'm going to read and kind of go in and explain various things from it and try to give a revelation for today and see how the Holy Spirit leads. We're just going to ask the Holy Spirit to have his way and take over and allow us to be able to see him a little bit more clearer. Again, we're going to go to 2 Chronicles, the 20th chapter, 2 Chronicles, the 20th chapter. And we're going to begin at that first verse. It said, "And it came to pass after this also that the children of Moab and the children of Ammon, and with them under beside the Ammonites, came against Jehoshaphat to battle. And there came some that told Jehoshaphat, saying, There cometh a great multitude against thee from beyond the sea on this side of Syria. And behold, they be Hazazon Tamar, which is Engannah. And Jehoshaphat feared and set himself to seek the Lord and proclaim a fast throughout all Judea." Stopping right there for a second, as we look at this and we see that three enemies were coming against the people of God. And today, as we look around across the world today, we see almost the same construct as well. We see coronavirus is trying to attack us. We see that our job and economy is beginning to fall and decline. And then also the aspect of being able to provide for our families, the threat of food shortages and things of that nature. We see the same attack almost being used to come against us as well. And we see that Jehoshaphat has some that are near to him. They came and gave him a message. And we can look at that as well as how the news is constantly coming in, giving us updates, coming in, giving us messages about the threat that's around us, about the various things that's going on around us. And we see in that third verse, Jehoshaphat feared. This is a commonality today. Many people, because of the unknown and the things that are going on, they're beginning to fear. They're beginning to fear. But we know, like I said in our sermon, that God did not give us a spirit of fear. He gave us a spirit of power, of love, and a sound mind. And those three things are very critical in this day and time. We need to know that we have the spirit of power. We have the Holy Spirit residing in us, able to give us just what we need. We also have the spirit of love. Even though we may not be able to touch our loved one, love can conquer a multitude of sin. So in this here season of time, we can cover them with love. We can pray that the love of God will reign supreme and reside throughout all the people. And also he gave us a spirit of sound mind. He gave us a spirit of a sound mind to know that we need to make the right decisions, that we needed to do things that are going to be pleasing to our God. It says Jehoshaphat feared, but see, look and see what Jehoshaphat did. The text says he set himself to seek the Lord. And that's one of the things that we must do during a time of crisis, especially when we don't know what's going on, but really in any times of our lives, we need to set ourselves to seek God. This is the one area that we're not doing. We think we're praying just one little quick prayer. We're asking God to cover us. But God said, if you want certain things, if you want your needs met, he says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And he says, all these other things will be added unto you. God is there to supply our needs. But we need to do our part too. We need to put God in his proper place. We need to let God know that the king's dominionship is over our lives. We need to know that we're seeking his righteousness, his right standards for us to live. We need to show God that we're trying to do our part as we're looking for him to do his part. The next thing you see in that verse 3, it said he proclaimed a fast throughout all Judea. Sometimes, my brother and sister, the Bible tells us that the flesh and the spirit war daily. They're trying to fight to conquer one another. Our fears, our emotions, our passions and everything are tied up into these here areas. And this is one of the main things that I believe that we need to do. We need to deny the flesh. We need to take the time to deny the flesh and allow God to say, look, we're going to subject the flesh so that the spirit man and feed the spirit man more of spiritual things. Feed him the word, feed him praise, feed him prayer, feed him seeking God, feed him conversating with God, feed him those things that he might get stronger. And in the midst of getting stronger, he'll be able to do a great thing for us. We're going to read a little bit more verse, starting in verse 4. It says, and Judea gathered themselves together to ask help of the Lord. Even out of all the cities of Judea, they came to seek the Lord. Look what they did. They gathered together. Now, I understand that we cannot gather right now, but what we can do, we can come together and set up a specific time and say, hey, we're going to have a solidarity time at 12 o'clock, at 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 6 o'clock, 9 o'clock, whatever it may be. We're going to come together in our comforts of our home, in our quiet places. We're going to come together and we're going to seek the help of the Lord. We're going to ask the help of the Lord. When we say an ask, that is praying. They are going to ask the Lord for help. And they said, even all the cities of Judea, they came to seek. Again, the Bible tells us where two or three come together, touching and agreeing. He says, I will be in the midst. In this situation, in this pandemic, this is what we need to do. We're not come together, and I understand we got to keep our social distancing, but what we can do, again, is use technology to our advantage and bring ourselves together and pray about this here very situation. As we go to verse 5, it says, and Jehoshaphat stood in the congregation of Judea and Jerusalem in the house of the Lord before the new court and said, O Lord God of our fathers, art not thou God in heaven? And rulest not that over the kingdoms of the heavens? And in thy hand is there not power and might, so that none is able to withstand thee? Art not thou our God, who didst drive out the inhabitants of this land before thy people Israel, and gave it to the seed of Abraham, thy friend forever? And they dwelt therein and built thee a sanctuary therein for the name, saying, if when evil come upon us, as a sword, judgment and pestilence or famine, we stand before this house in thy presence, for the name is in this house, and cry unto thee in our affliction, when thou wilt hear and help. And now, behold, the children of Ammon and the Moab and Mount Seir, whom thou wouldest not let Israel invade when they come out of the land of Egypt, but they turn from them and destroy them not. Behold, I say, how they reward us to come to cast us out of this possession which thou hast given us to inherit. O our God, will thou not judge them? For we have no might against this great company that cometh against us. I want to stop right there for a second. I want to show you something. In the sermon, I went in and I showed you how Jehoshaphat, as he prayed, as a leader, he stood in position as the leader, not the high priest, but as the leader of the people and sought out God for the people. The next thing I want to show you is that he went back in and he went back and remembered the prayer of Solomon. Solomon made a covenant with God, and that covenant on prayer, he said, God, if we do this, would you come in and save us? Would you come in and deliver us from the various enemies, from the various pestilence, from the various famines? Would you do this here? And in verse, in 2 Chronicles 7 and 14, God answered him. He said, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves, pray, turn from their wicked ways and seek my face, he says, then I will forgive their sins and heal their, I will hear from heaven, forgive their sins and heal their land. If we look at this right here, he went back in and he brought back up old covenantal promises. What we need to learn to pray is sometimes we need to go back and pray those old promises of God. We need to go back in like they used to pray. I said in the sermon, as they used to go in, they pray them old prayers or whatnot. We laugh at them nowadays, but they had so much meaning back then. They were sincere in their prayer. They probably couldn't pray long prayers. They didn't have a very big vocabulary to do various things. But what they did have was sincerity. And in that sincerity, they prayed those old promises of God. What we need also today is pray the promises that God has given. God, you said you would never leave us nor forsake us. You said all things will work together for the good of them who are called according to your name and your purpose and love you. You said, Father God, that you are the battle axe. You said, oh, Father God, because you are my salvation, why should I fear? Your word tells us various things, and we need to go back in and pray the word of God back to the people of God. And that last part of verse 12, it says, neither know we what to do, but our eyes are upon you. Again, when we are in a situation like we are now, when we don't know what to do, when we don't know where our help is coming from a physical perspective, from this government, we need to look to the Lord. We need to look to the hills from which cometh our help, because our help comes from God. Even though man may not have a cure, God already has a cure. God is waiting on us to come in and look to him. He's waiting on us to do our part, to deny the flesh, to seek his holy and righteous face. Look to him to provide the comfort that we need. We need a healing. We need intervention. We need God in this situation. And we must do like they are showing us here in this 20th chapter. Look to the Lord. Verse 13 says, beginning at verse 13, it says, and all Judah stood before the Lord with their little ones, their wives, and their children. Everyone came together looking for intervention by God. We need to do the same thing. We need to look, come together. Big, young, old, everybody needs to come together. We're in a situation where God can intervene on our behalf, and we know that God delivers his people. We just have to go in and do our part in order for God to come in. Verse 14 says, then upon Jehaziel, the son of Zechariah, the son of Benaiah, the son of Jeriel, and the son of Mattaniah, a Levite of the son of Asaph, came the Spirit of the Lord in the midst of the congregation. The prophet brought the prophecy. After the people did what they were supposed to do, the prophet brought the prophecy from the Lord. The Spirit of the Lord came upon the congregation. It came in the midst. And listen to what it said. And he said, hearken ye all Judea and ye inhabitants of Jerusalem, and thou King Jehoshaphat, thus saith the Lord unto you, be not afraid nor dismayed by any reason this great multitude. He's saying here, do not have that spirit of fear. Have the spirit of power. Have the spirit of love. Have the spirit of a sound mind. He says, do not fear because of these situations that are coming against the people right now. He says, for the battle is not yours, but God. This is a powerful statement. If we will go in and lay down this here situation at the feet of God, if we will show him, Lord, that we are helpless and we can only depend on you, we can only look to you, we can only come back to you to get the help that we need, God can come back then in the midst of us and show us that the battle is not really ours. God, his covenantal promise is to provide and protect. And these are the things that we need right now. These are the things that we need. Our part in the covenant is to be obedient and loyal to our God. And if we be obedient and loyal to our God and allow God to be the protector and provider, God will do his part on our behalf. And it says here in that 15, and he said, hearken ye all of Judea's inhabitants. Oh, I'm sorry. Verse 16, tomorrow go ye down against them. Behold, they're come up by the cliff of Zeal, and ye shall find at the end of the brook before the wilderness of Jeriel. He's saying here, I need you to understand that I'm going to fight this battle for you. Yes, you can go out and confront it. You can go out there to walk towards it. But in the end, I'm going to fight this. I'm going to give you the plan of action, and I need you to do it. Look what he says in verse 17. He said, ye shall not need to fight in this battle. Stand ye still and see the salvation of the Lord with you. O Judea and Jerusalem, fear not, nor be dismayed. Tomorrow go up against them, for the Lord will be with you. He said a powerful thing for us. He said, you don't need to fight this. I got it. I'm going to go in and fight this battle for you. You don't need to fight it. All I need you to do is stand still and see the salvation. I need you to be out in the presence to show me that you're going to make a step of faith, that you're going to go out and move in faith, knowing that I'm going to do this for you. And if you move in faith, if you show me that you trust me completely, he said, you will be able to see, you will be able to stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. And he said, once you see this, I don't need you to be scared, because we know doubt and fear cancels out our faith. We know all those things go against us versus towards. He said, don't be fearful. Don't be dismayed. He said, just go out there in faith and knowing that I'm going to be with you. In this season, my brothers and sisters, we need to stand in faith. We need to forsake everything else and trust God. We need to put our complete trust in God. We need to know that God can bring us through this here as well. Verse 18, it says, and Jehoshaphat bowed his head with his face to the ground, and all of Judea and the heavens of Jerusalem fell before the Lord, worshiping. There is that next thing. We need to understand that as God gives us revelation, as the word of God gives us revelation on what we need to do, we need to stop and stand, fall down and pray. We need to pray to God and ask God and worship him, for what he has given us, knowing that he is the way out of no way. He is the bridge over troubled water. He is that door opener. We need to go in and look at this here, because this here 20th chapter is a very powerful chapter. And in verse 19 says, and the Kohites of the children of the Levites of the children of the Kohathites and the children of the Korahites stood up to praise the Lord God of Israel with a loud voice. Notice here, they started the praise celebration early. They started it right after worship. They begin to praise God for his answer. They begin to praise God for his intervention. They begin to praise God. And that's the thing that we need to do as well. We need to praise God. In that 20th verse, and they rose early in the morning and went forth in the wilderness of Tekoa. And as they went forth, Jehoshaphat stood and said, hear me, O Judea, and ye inhabitants of Jerusalem, believe in the Lord your God, so shall ye be established. Believe ye the prophets, so shall ye prosper. Notice what he said. He gave a proclamation. The leader stood up and went back in and asked them to believe. He asked them to put trust in God. Trust what the word says. Trust what the prophet says. Trust what is going on, what God has already said. And this is the thing that we need leaders to do now. We need the leaders to come in and reestablish our faith in the situation. Reestablish our faith in God. Too many of us are just going home and we just say we're going to close shop to go in and cancel services. But are we doing things, leaders, that's going to help us to put the trust back in God, to put our eyes back on the Lord, put our eyes back on him? And he says in verse 20, he said, when they had consulted with the people and appointed singers unto the Lord, and he said that they should praise the beauty of holiness as they went out before the army and say, praise the Lord for his mercy and do it forever. And it says, and when they began to sing and to praise the Lord, set an ambushment against the children of Ammonites. The Lord set ambushments against the children of Ammonites, Moab and Mount Seir, which were come against Judah, and they were smiting. Notice what initiated the attack. Praise. The Bible tells us that God inhabits the praises of his people. So when Jehoshaphat showed God, I'm going to trust you so much that I'm going to put the army in the back and I'm going to put praise up front. Sometimes, my brothers and sisters, what I said in the sermon as well, sometimes we got to praise our way through some things. Sometimes you got to go and connect yourself to your favorite song, to your favorite hymnal, to your spot where you can get to a place where you can praise God and praise God through this situation. I invite you now to really get in and look at this, how they came together and allowed praise to initiate God's beacon call. It was like the bell for God to begin the assault. It was like the bell that God needed to go in and to wipe the enemy out. Verse 23 says, for the children of Ammonite and Moab stood up against the mount inhabitants of Mount Seir, utterly slay and destroyed them. And when they had made an end to the inhabitants of Seir, everyone helped to destroy them. And when Judea came towards the watchtower in the wilderness, they looked unto the multitude, and behold, there were dead bodies falling to the earth, and none escaped. And when Jehoshaphat and his people came to take away the spoils of them, they found among them in abundance both riches and dead bodies and precious jewels, which they had stripped off of themselves more than they could carry away. And they were 3 days in gathering of the spoils. It was much. Notice this here. God used the situation of praise to go in and defeat the enemy. But in that same situation, he allowed his people to go in and reap the benefits of their worship, their praise, their prayer, their fasting, and their seeking of God. They prospered off of this right here. Yes, I know everything is going down. I know the stock market is going down. I know jobs are laying off. I know grocery stores are not stocked. I know it seems like it's dire times, but as we see here, when we do it God's way, God will go back and replenish. He go back in and allow them to go in and gather the spoils. So whatever that we do that falls by the wayside, if it's about God, if it's for God, God can replenish it. God can bring it back. So my brothers, I want you to go back in today. As we look at this here as a season of going in, yes, we preach this here. We went in and like I said, we got happy about the preaching, but God gave us, the Holy Spirit gave us an insight to come back in and really sit down and give you a rhema word today to really explain that there are things that we need to do. We need to go in and, like I say, seek out the Lord. We don't know what to do. We need to seek out God. And in seeking out God, we need to go in, even though we're fearful, even though we know we don't know what's the next thing is going to come up, we need to fast. Maybe can't fast from food, but you can fast from something that this flesh really likes, that you can deny that flesh. Next, we need to do the three P's. We need to pray, allow the prophecy to come up upon us, and then praise our God. And in praising our God, we get that final, the four P. We will profit in the end, whether it be physically, spiritually, or monetarily, however God sees fit to bless us, we will profit. And when we go in and do it God's way, we can go in and be blessed. I'd like to thank you today again, my brother and sister, for coming in to listen. This has again been a JCC word on Sunday morning. This is a rhema word that God came back and gave me. I feel the Holy Spirit again said, come back in and begin to teach this lesson. You all be blessed and continue to keep everyone in prayer. Be blessed now.